In my chest, I'm ready to space it. Call me a friend. You know that you're loving. Call me no disrespect. Right to be hers. I still get jealous. You're too sexy, beautiful. Everybody wants a taste, that's why. I still get jealous. You're too sexy, beautiful. Everybody wants a taste, that's why. I still get jealous. You're the only one to hide it. No one else like you. And all that young California. I still get jealous. You're too sexy, beautiful. Everybody wants a taste, that's why. I still get jealous.
Oh. Yes, that's even after what you put in my water at the apartment. Haven't eaten. Yes, this, I live in this jacket. It's time to do laundry. It's one of two hoodies that I own. I 104.7 KDUK.
You did. I'm all alone. I'm behind your glory, fighting for you. Without Me, Halsey up four to number four. We're getting closer to the number one song. This next band has been massively growing in popularity lately, which leads to bigger and better shows. But lead singer Dan Smith says that nothing makes him more nervous than performing in front of huge crowds. He's not letting his nerves hold him back, though, especially since releasing this song. Everyone wants to see them play. It's Bastille and Marshmello, Happier, number three.
Lately, I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. When the morning comes and we see what we've become. In the cold light of day, we're aflame in the wind of the fire.
He is not the lesser Adam Levine of the British style. But thank you for thinking that in. That's fucking funny.
I want to change my mind. This doesn't feel right to me. I want to raise my spirits. I want to see you smile. No matter what I have to be. I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. When the evening falls, and I'm left there with my thoughts, and the image of you being with someone else, while they're seating me up inside. But we run our course, we pretended we're okay. Now if we jump together, at least we can swim far away.
Yes, this is how you make it look like Don Sly sucks paid ass.
For a minute, I want to change my mind, cause this is only right to me. I want to raise your spirits. I want to see you smile. You're not the only half of me.
They Photoshop it.
No, that means I have to be. Lately, I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. So I'll go. I will go. So I'll go. I will go. Lately, I've been thinking, I want you to be happier. I want you to be happier. Even though I wouldn't like this, I want that I'll be happier. I want you to be happier. And only for a minute, I want to change my mind. This is all right to me. I want to raise your spirits. No, that means I'll have to be.
If you're searching for talent for somebody to fill up bands, you're getting ripped off because they're just taking recordings of me and surrounding it with accessories. And people know my identity, so you might as well bow out and hand the crown to me.
I will go.
Number one. That falls to three for Marshmello and Bastille.
I didn't actually see it, but if you were in downtown Eugene last night, which hopefully you were, because you were told to come catch me to do something. Sort of something spontaneity out there. I picked up dinner with Rowan, my friend, where I'm staying on the floor at his apartment in Eugene, not far from Jefferson, not far from the fairgrounds, Jefferson Street, and cleared out of there pretty early, so I wasn't involved in any of the spectacles. Moobicles became the name of the Spectrum because Spectrum moved them to Spectacles
And then they looked that up and found out that spectacles was just really fancy talk of saying glasses, like eyewear. And so from there, they took it one further and realized that moobicles could mean a couple of things. My original definition was that they were either moobs. Again, moobs are boobs on a man. I would tend to think that the M part is male because boys can have moobs as well. It's a problem that can be detected early and treated with proper consultation. But there's been a healthcare crisis lately and a shortage of funds to treat the proper conditions because other people that don't know how to fill out forms are stealing the insurance for things like emergency surgery for having 4 tiny peckers removed from fingertips. I'm not talking about birds. What I'm talking about here are a tiny phalluses. Technically, these were dildos. Don't ask me why anybody wants 3-inch long. I'll get back to moobicles. It's coming back around because it's going to make more sense. It's easy to implant ideas to people who are really open to being perverts. And so when the game Quest4Moobicles was sent out to a select few invitations to participate, one of the things that was encoded was this idea that to put something on their fingertips, like olives, to get going. And apparently the closest thing were tiny dildos in this case. And so I don't want to give away the identity, because I think if I start talking about who started the trend, that well, it could compromise their identity and their location and all that. So stealing insurance is really not a good idea, but for something like, they were ordered to fill the tips of these particular penile with a milky substance. Elmer's glue didn't have quite the right consistency, and it didn't really set up right. It kind of leaked all over, and so somebody took some, they actually were inspired by watching Romeo and Michelle's high school reunion and got the idea to look into some epoxies and some kind of naturally occurring products, some ways to firm up the glue, but yet maybe not have it set very quickly. What she didn't take into account is that perhaps that if this particular substance were allowed to gel for a while, that maybe the what was meant to be temporary, and in the original intent, it's not like this was an accident. It's actually brilliance, because it allows you to work with this, with the item, whatever you're using this particular epoxy on, to be able to move it for a little bit and get into the right place and have some time to position it and really know what you want to do with that piece before it becomes essentially permanent. There may or may not be another substance that counteracts, but apparently there was funding that ran out, and so the horse came before the cart, gotta be careful when I say things like that around this particular group, but, and somebody rushed into something that hadn't been fully product tested yet in any legal way and insisted that this happen. Because they're really bad listeners, they approved things before realizing the, you know, temporary to permanent. They just, they didn't really listen to anything at all. So presidential approval was given to this particular item. It was rushed through. FDA looked the other way. That's what they like to say. And, they were able to not only participate in the very first pilot run of Quest4Moobicles, the computer game, they had their party snacks of these... yes, this does explain a lot. Of these fingertip items, a couple people were inspired to actually get olives. They opened up a can, and they thought that they were not gonna go with the penis option, that they were going to go with the olive option, which to them felt like a declaration of they came out. It was a coming out party with olives, okay? They decided not to go for the penis. They wanted to be the female end and not the male end. And so they ended up being able to survive this whole thing. They saw what was happening on the computer game. They ate the olives and videotaped the rest of what was happening so we could get the perspective from behind, because this particular group of men like it better from behind, and but the front view is also included as well. So Vladdy and DJ were in the front row, and they kind of freaked out because there was the time travel program had been going, but it shut down because of misuse. People were going back in time to assault people and change genetics and steal things and get sports scores and game books and really, you know, lottery winnings and that kind of stuff. And so the program was shut down. It was opened very briefly, and there, again, they don't read very well, and so they basically let the smart people go ahead and select probably the most critical historic moment of history. And this brilliant group of scientists went ahead and went forward a couple of weeks and videotaped Trump and Putin each with four. They tried to go for five, but they heard that the society is evolving towards more of thumbs use instead of forefingers use. And so they kept the thumbs free. It's one of their sayings, thumbs free. But when they've cleared the bunghole, thumbs free! So they, for some reason, they didn't. And plus they have fat thumbs, so they couldn't fit in there. And so the they videotaped their... At first, they decided to tinkly fingers, because they thought if they put four of those on each finger, that would increase their power. And it was powered by dick, so it would be really, like, you know, intense. And so that's what they did for a little while. And then I think they tried to see what, if they could find any holes for that to fit. But they're such big assholes that they imploded their own holes. So that was basically, that explains a couple of people who had lip injuries later on. Unfortunately, things hadn't set yet, so they just replaced things. So there were a couple of interesting problems with holes, I'll just say. And so ultimately what happened is that the computer that they were using was meant for me, and it's a very, very nice computer. It's a gaming computer. It also has touch screen. It's very sensitive, but for some reason it couldn't handle the tips of these little rubber dildos poking at the screen, and, you know, stuff kept coming out, and then it would kind of stick, and that's only good for some things. And so there were some gestures involved, and there were some things happening, and basically the whole sequence ends with them typing with their dong fingers, and that was what the time travel program used to document the most historical moment ever. I don't really want to analyze it right now because it's just really, it's all coming together for me right now. And so I need a little bit of time to eat. I haven't eaten yet today, and to get some Earl Grey tea and with some cream and be able to think about this a little while before I have a reaction about it, because I'm just, you know, I just got the last piece or two to put it all together to do this nice summary for everyone. But I just again want to commend the whole team that had the foresight to put this together, because Quest4Moobicles was such a hit that it went out everywhere with the opening sequence. And then I don't know how they did this, but to have the opening sequence come up and then to have it switch to a live cut of what you had just watched happening, because they filmed it in the future. And so it was like, it was a mind fuck. It was just like, what the hell happened? Like, I just saw this really cool thing. Not really cool. This is not maybe the wrong words. I'm sorry about that. But I just saw this and I'm freaking out going, why are Donald J. Trump and Vladimir Putin tinkly fingerings tiny wieners around, poking them into places that don't belong, not only causing some vet bills, there were some people on board because they were under the impression that this was some sort of movie set or TV show, and so they gave permission for it to be filmed. The olive eaters weren't really quite sure yet, but when they saw what was happening, they made sure that everything was fully documented. So, it was kind of like this whole moment of everybody realizing that Don Sly didn't go out, but somebody stole her phone and fired up Periscope TV, and everybody was waiting for that particular show to come on. And so while they're watching the show, and then they're logging on, and they're like, oh my god, there is a game on the computer that you can do on your phone, that you can do on your tablet, that you can do basically on any platform. Everybody tried it. Somebody even, as a joke, fired up an NES, an old ancient Nintendo Entertainment System, and it was available there for them to watch the occurrence. And nobody's realized till now what they were seeing was, again, future footage of the game starting, and then the reaction of Vladdy and DJ, and then the reenactment of what had just been watched to open the game. If you want to think about that for a while, it's a lot, again, a lot to think about. This I just turned this on and am doing it kind of off the cuff. And so, again, I apologize for not being fully organized, but it's just something that came to me in my sleep last night, and I feel that it's important to share it with people because it's a damn good explanation. Camp David is the Oregon State Psychiatric Hospital, which is in Junction City, Oregon. They decided to just go ahead and change the address. So, I am gonna swing it on back to where this whole thing got started. I'm really sorry that I got off track. I didn't mean to get that far off, and now I'm gonna be accused of not being able to stay on track and being not unfocused and, you know, maybe not including participants in the audience as well as I should. But the original intent of what I started discussing was that they looked up spectacles and realized that Moobicles, at first my definition of Moobicles was that they could be moobs, male boobs, that look like testicles. Or they could be testicles that look like moobs. I think everybody was on board when I started with moobs, but with they're into testicles, but if they look like moobs, some of them don't like breasts that much. No matter if they're male or female. And then testicles are nice, but on the chest, and I mean, it literally allows you to identify the big dick in the middle of them. And I think probably that was the biggest reason that they decided that they weren't really down with that idea, because everybody already knows they're giant dicks. So, the giant dicks. So who needs to call attention by having a couple of dangling testes right there? So, they did a little bit of research and came up with alternate, words that ended in coals, and they were able to come up with spectacles. And so Moobicles is an act of viewing somebody with moobs. It's a little clever voyeur shout out to a peeping Tom kind of thing. And it bypasses the original intent, and it makes them feel good, and it helped launch the whole scandal. It's called Moobsgate. Some people are calling it Moobs Knuckles Gate, because I had brought up a couple of things pretty publicly. I don't have access to media, so I'm really not fully aware of how much attention it gathered, but this whole need for, you know, helping DJ be able to come out and be able to, you know, really examine his inner manliness and admit who he is. I mean, somebody who orders Don Sly to have to sit through Road to El Dorado to pretend she's on a visit with her 5-year-old daughter, is super gay and doesn't realize it. I had never seen that movie before. I don't think I'm going to hurt anybody's feelings, because apparently somebody got in control and took things over for that particular movie, or I was shown a version that wasn't originally aired. I'm not really sure which, but either is kind of a little bit of a cause for concern. I am totally, totally down with pro male buddies and bromance and all that, but at some point, like, you should just come out. You're out naked, and I mean, naked in the water, and then, like, partway through somebody, like, you tells them, clearly it's like, you guys, this is super gay, you need to throw a woman in here, and so one, they literally have, like, them sneaking off and humping behind the best friend's back, and it's like, you know, bros before hoes type of thing, and they put the hoe first, and it's really a disgusting message, and it's like, oh, the woman gets to choose between these two white guys that think they're gods. Like, it was very, very, very odd. I am a lesbian. I'm pro-homosexual. I don't know. That movie was, like, a train wreck. It was, I really, really don't understand. I fell asleep halfway through it, not because anything to do with the movie. I was tired. I don't really know what to say about that at all. But that allowed the channel that people thought I was on to continue to keep going. Plus, the computer had all these permission things in place because they thought it was for me, and so it linked into international streaming TV to, like, because they thought it was going to be like the universal presidential address. Instead, they get DJ and Vladdy firing up Quest4Moobicles. So that wasn't a nightmare. Well, it was kind of a nightmare, but it was real. Again, you just have to imagine where it's going to be, and you can see it. Some people in places where they have absolutely no access to any type of video screen or technology were able to see it just fine wherever they wanted. So, I will wrap it up and just briefly explain where the gate part comes in, is that they got the idea. All right, I had sent a email to Rachel Maddow about 3 years ago, basically warning her that some scary, weird shit was going on, and that it was, like, you know, just giving her a heads up, and I sent her some letters that were weird, my family used and changed names and all sorts of things. And so I hashtagged one of the things. I also had a whole bunch of social media that was blocked. They pretended like I was dead or missing. And I hashtagged one thing, moose knuckles. And for some reason, I don't know. I think she's, like, just must have missed this as far as the whole gay and lesbian culture. But maybe... I'm assuming that, never mind, I don't want to label that anyway. So, she wasn't privy to what moose knuckles meant, and it kind of became a whole thing, and it was like this whole funny thing, and they were like, you know, where did moose knuckles come from? Like, from Don Sly, because I sent that, you know, like, I'm the creator of moose knuckles. It's like, no, I did not create moose knuckles, but I did give it a lot of promotion. if that means I need to be labeled that, I'm proud to be able to promote that way. I should be able to get paid somehow. But for those of you who haven't looked it up yet, moose knuckles is the male equivalent of camel toe. And that might throw some of you off too, some people that aren't English speakers or that just haven't heard it, you know, called that term. But camel toe is when a female wears pants or shorts or something with legs way so tight that you can see the outline of their vagina lips. Camel toe, because it looks like, you know, like camel toe. Camels have two toes and there's a slit up the front. So go from there. Moose knuckles are men who wear pants that are so tight you can see the outline of their moose knuckles. I haven't looked at moose knuckles very closely, so I don't even really know if they're things that exist, because they have hooves, and knuckles are usually something that are on hands, but my immediate thought is maybe they mean that thing on the front of the leg. I'm not really sure. But the thing that's really funny is that nobody at Willamette Family, even though a lot of people who have taken over the administration are rather perverted, they didn't get the memo from Rachel Maddow, and they didn't do the research. And so they thought, and coincidentally, this is just, it's hard to say coincidentally, because it's like, it's like if there is a God, like it was orchestrated to be, because at Willamette Family Incorporated here in Eugene, Oregon, they had an executive director that was dear and beloved and established many of the programs, and her name is Mickey Knuckles. And there's a large memorial wall when you walk in, and they've named a couple programs after her. And it's, again, this is just like, wow about it. But her name is Mickey Knuckles. I don't know if this was originally a thing or if somebody went back in time, because it just made it oh so delicious. But her nickname was Moose. And so people called her, you know, it would be like Mickey with Moose in the quotations and then Knuckles. And some people just started shortening it to Moose Knuckles, because then it would be hard to trace back exactly who that is, because how many people have the nickname Moose? I mean, a lot of people around here. It became a trend, I think, within the last 2 years, where that's like, you know, instead of saying like boo or honey or whatever, it's like Moose about things. And so it's in certain communities. I don't think it's caught on everywhere, but around here they felt that it was a way to be able to get some packages without being able to know where they came from. And some of them might be, cocaine or meth. And if they go to the U of O, it's like, oh, well, that's for our special research project. We've got a really good project to see how methamphetamine affects in utero development by giving it to willing victims to see how it affects how, you know, we'll put it in their, they'll get their medication and we'll see how that affects the, we'll get data from them, and we need an infrared truck and we need 3 trucks. And can we decorate them like police officers? 'Cause we don't want to freak out the general public. not police officers. We need them to look like police trailers, like, you know, like those things that tell you if you're speeding too fast and, you know, those things. Because we don't want to alarm people that we're having this project go on. And so, and to make it natural, like, you know, blind, then we'll just do all these things. And so the people, the participants aren't going to really act like they know what's happening. We'll trick them into all these things so it's natural. So, that's what we've got going on. And they started to get a lot of packages. And they have a lot of drugs in them. And they have a lot of other things in them that aren't okay. And I made this funny because it kind of is fucking funny, but it also is very real. Donald Trump is getting drugs, loading them up into mail vehicles, Toys for Tots, which are still running after Christmas. Large vehicles, they're pulling out army convoy things. I'm not familiar, I've never been in the services. My stepfather was in the Navy for a little bit when I was little. And they are stealing the fuck out of people's things. They're transferring Amazon things to this name. And basically when they get caught with them, they say, oh, well, I'm just doing this or I'm just doing that. And people are changing their name to that legally to accept the packages. At first they were doing it with my name, but then people started to tell them they traveled internationally and found out people knew who the fuck I was and are waiting for them to compensate me the right way. And waiting for them to realize that I'm not crazy and I do have the connections. And I think the local mafioso pretenders that try to put on a little show to scare me to see if I were really who I said I would shut up and fucking leave by what they did at a School of Blues event that is a for-profit thing that they're stealing money that I have no affiliation with. I don't think those guys are around anymore because I was live streaming, and when somebody's doing like this, and then it causes a 16-year-old girl's throat to get cut, she's learned sign language really fast. And it was filmed. That's really good evidence. So, the Congress today voted fully for impeachment. And I already sent over fresh impeachments for them. It's a new product. It's a peach with a mint inside. They all voted for it. Have a good day.